Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about minor ailments in community health nursing, and this is our last unit in community health nursing. So let's understand what does it mean by minor ailments. So the minor ailments can be defined as slight illnesses, which is less life threatening. Okay, or you can define the minor ailments like the medical conditions which is resolved by their own without any prescribed medication. Okay, so the minor ailments, it is very important in community health nursing to finding out and to identify this kind of minor ailments, and afterwards to give proper preventive measure as well as to treat that kind of illnesses is very important in community health nursing. Okay, so this kind of illnesses or your minor ailments, it is divided into two types. Okay, first one is your general and second one is your systemic. Okay, so let's understand that. So your minor ailments can be classified into two types. First one is your general. So in general, it includes common accidents and emergency which need immediate post. So all kind of accidents, okay, which need immediate first aid treatment. That kind of cases will be coming under your general minor ailments. So in this category, take an example of some injuries, some falls or some dog bite, some snake bite, any kind of burn or fever or diarrhea or fainting. Okay, this kind of cases will be coming under your general minor ailments which needs immediate first aid treatment. Okay, so next is your second is your systemic minor ailments. Okay, systemic means it will affect or it will be seen all over the body. Maybe it will affect our eye, maybe the illness, it will occur inside our ear, okay, our digestive system or our cardiovascular system, right? So that is why it is called systemic minor ailment. So take an example of eye. Here you can see, suppose any accident will occur or any injury will be occur or some foreign bodies it will enter inside the eye. Okay, so this all are the illnesses which will occur inside the eye as well as inside the ear. Here you can see some foreign body if it will enter inside the ear. Okay, some infection will be occur inside the ear or some discharges. Okay, this all the illnesses, it will be coming under your systemic minor ailments. Okay, here you can see in respiratory system, common cold, sore throat, okay, cough, chest pain, asthma, okay, as well as in your cardiovascular system, some hypertension, okay, and rheumatic heart disease also, it will be coming under your minor ailments. Okay, and in your digestive system also, here you can see soreness in the mouth or some stomatitis will be there, some diarrhea, indigestion. Okay, this all are the minor illnesses which will be coming under your systemic minor ailments. Okay, same wise in your urinary system, some infection will be there. Okay, in your neuromuscular system, some convulsion, epileptic. Okay, in reproductive system also, some heavy bleeding will be there. Okay, painful menstruation. Okay, some breast lump also, it will be coming under your systemic minor ailments. Okay, next, management of minor ailments. How you are going to, or how the community health nurse, they are going to manage. First, she should take the history. Okay, in assessment phase, she should take the history. And she should do the physical examination as well to find out the illness. Okay, after finding out the causes, she should and diagnosis, the physician have to diagnose the disease, and after a while they should plan to how they are going to treat the disease. Okay, and after all the things they should evaluate, okay, whether that outcome to the patient, it is successful or not, right? So here it is, you can see assessment, finding the cause, providing treatment, evaluating. We need to follow the nursing process. This, okay, systematically we should do to reach our goal. Okay, and after evaluating, suppose if the condition of the patient, it is not improving, immediately the nurse has to refer that kind of patient to the hospital to save the life of the patient, right? So this was all about your minor ailments. Okay, so the minor ailments is defined as slight illnesses, right? It can be divided into general, which needs immediate positive treatment, and systemic minor ailments. Okay, systemic means the illnesses will be occur over inside the body. Maybe it will be occur inside the ear, or maybe it will be occur inside the your mouth, or it will affect your digestive system or reproductive system, right? That is why it is called systemic minor ailments. Okay, so this was all about minor ailments. In our next class, we will be learning about the standing orders. Okay, thank you.